As soon as video, I'll be showing you guys how to drive a car. Now, of course, this is for, you know, my younger viewers, so like teenagers. So, hope you enjoy. We're older, I guess, too. Now, if you have a key like this, just a standard key. Obviously, you have trunk, unlock, lock, and don't ever push this button unless you want the alarm to go off. So, first lesson. So, if you have a newer car, you just press the button. Now, this is a 2010, so you just take the key. And you do it like that. Alright, so now, we're going to show you the interior of how you would start the car and all that good stuff. So, obviously, you get in the car, obviously. And if you don't have a push button, you just obviously you push it. Stand push button. You have a key like this. Now for the young kids out there who probably never experienced or were probably too young to understand a key, this kind of key. Let me show you. And so just take the key like this. You just find the keyhole. You just stick it in there like that. And you stick it like that. You got your gear shifters and everything. Obviously. And obviously it's going to complain about the hood. And of course you got your air conditioner, and this is a automatic. So obviously you have your park, reverse, neutral. Neutral will disconnect the engine and transmission, so don't ever put a neutral unless you really need to. Now also, you want to keep a neutral like if you're still, but if you're like in traffic or something, don't ever put a neutral. And of course drive, which is here. This is manual mode. Now I drive manual mode because I know how to drive a manual. But if you don't know how to drive manual, don't do it. You will destroy the transmission and that'll be the end of the car. So whatever you do, don't ever do it if you don't know manual. Now for young kids, so they probably have no clue that I hope they would know what this is. CD player. Obviously you can take a disc, CD disc, put it in there. This is to eject it. And obviously the radio parts. This is the power to radio on, the turn, tune it. Stuff in there, obviously. And of course, most important, obviously, is seatbelt, but that's obvious. And of course, your RPMs. And then, you know, obviously, your top speed. This you don't want to mess with because that'll mess up your. You only want to do it if you want to reset it, but you don't want to turn it or mess it up because it'll mess with the mileage and that's illegal. And of course, you got your ASC off. It turns off, I can't remember what exactly. Now, if you want your. Usually, you know, unless you're all cars, but a Japanese car, because I only drive Japanese cars usually. You got your gas cap, your trunk, and of course you got your hood release. And right here, you got your circuit board there. I don't want to mess with that too much, but yeah. And obviously for newer cars, you know, you have the buttons on the wheel, so. Something you play music on. It's like a phone, but it's not a phone, but it's like a phone. Where it can be touch screen or a little button and it plays music. So you have just to clear the air here. And you got your paddle shifters here, which is why in this car I don't drive manual because I find it very annoying. I don't like paddle shifters. Like I like the where you just go front up shift to down shift. But I don't like this paddle shifting crap. It drives me crazy. And that just about wraps up, really. Oh, and the emergency brake. If you have an emergency, obviously you pull this up and pull it forward. Now, before you go, in case you're wondering, yes, this is not factory. This is an aftermarket part I put on. An aftermarket part I put on to give it a chrome carbon fiber look. So, obviously, the Lancer GTS does not come with that, obviously. Actually, real quick, you just got your wipers. You don't want to because the hood's open, but you push this back and it sprays your window and you push it and put that in that. This is your turn signal. This is your turn signal for Japanese car size. turns the fog lights on. If you have fog lights in your car, of course. And you just turn it again to turn it off. And just to turn it off, you just turn it like that. Alright, I'm keeping. Usually it says see you, but you know, because I guess because I have to keep the door open. And then you just got your basic things here. And in case you're wondering, usually on newer cars it looks a little bit different, but older cars, this is what you used to use to light up your cigarettes. Now, I don't like to use stickers, I just use it for electronics, but you know. And this car receives it to the MP3. You hook it up to here with a special wire. Kind of a stupid design on the Mitsubishi, but what can you do? Alright, well, so I could think I've probably done for the basics for the drive. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Like, comment, subscribe. Videos, there are so many videos, especially an educational video like this, especially to make sure to share it. And just remember always, it's a safety first, seatbelt, you know, make sure your signals drive safely and responsibly, and always remember wear your seatbelt, you know, all that good stuff. And stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.